We're going to continue working on our cats versus dogs infographic, and it's time to start creating some graphs. The first one we're going to create is a graph using icons to represent numerical values. This graph that represents the percentage of households owning dogs and cats is being represented by an array of little house icons, each icon representing one house or 1% of households. If we look at this, we can see that we have 36.5% of households owning dogs and 30.4% of households owning cats. These percentages represent one portion of 100%, which means that we need to have 10 times 10 houses, 10 rows of 10 houses each, in order to represent 100. And the number of houses that are in color correspond to the percentage. So here, if we have 36.5% of households owning dogs, we have 36.5 house icons in color. And here where we have 30.4% of households owning cats, we have 30.4 house icons in color. We need to grab an icon. So go to File, Open, and in the Resources folder, under Vector Art, there's a pet document. Let's open that. Let's zoom in on our house icon. And on the house icon, I'm just going to release compound path and then select that house. It'll separate it from the paw print. And Command C to copy, go over to the cats and dogs infograph, Command V to paste. We're going to be working in this area, so I'm going to lock this dog object. And I already have my layer panel open. So under the artwork layer, I can see my dog object. I'm just going to click the lock icon so that I can't accidentally select that. I'm going to make my house icon this neutral color. So I'll just drag the swatch over to that. We're going to start out by making our house 28 points wide. We'll adjust it later, but for now, let's just do 28 points. So I'm going to go to the transform, and let's make sure that this link is clicked that will constrain the proportions. And under width, let's make it 28 pixels. Next, we can go to the effect menu. Choose Distort and Transform, choose Transform. We're going to create an array of objects. So first what we're going to do is we're going to create a row of 10 of these houses, and we want it to go horizontally. So we're going to space them 30 pixels apart, or have them move 30 pixels from the original position. And then we're going to make 10 copies. Actually, we'll make 9 copies because we have our original. Let's put the preview on so we can see. So we need 9 copies plus our original, which equals 10, and we can check OK. All right, so what we have is our original object that is editable, and then we have an array of instances of this object, which we can't directly edit, but we'll fix that later. So now that we have one row of 10 houses, we need 10 rows of 10 houses. So I'm going to, with this house still selected, I'm going to go back to Effect. Let's go to Transform. Let's choose Apply New Effect. And then we're going to keep the 30 pixels, but we're going to make it, we want it to be vertical. So let's do 30 pixels, and then we need 9 copies again. We can preview this. And now we have 100 houses. Let's hit OK. All right, so what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to edit some of these houses so that we can change the color. And as it is now, if I can't edit these, as I mentioned before. If I try to select one of these houses, what it's actually doing is it's selecting the original. And whatever I do to the original is going to be applied to all these copies. So let's say we wanted to change just some of these houses to purple, and I choose purple, it's going to change all of them. But before we do that, let's let's make a copy of this because we need one array each, one for dogs and one for cats. So I'm going to Command C and Shift Command V to put paste in place, and I'm going to move that copy out of the way. What we can do is start positioning this where we are going to want it to be. And I'm going to turn on my guides so I can see where this is going to align. And actually what I want is a little bit of an indent from the guide. So I'm going to drag out another guide here and I'm going to make that indent slightly. All right, so that position looks okay. I can always make some adjustments later. For now, let's go ahead and let's start transforming these objects so that we can edit each one individually. I'm going to select my original object in the array. I'm going to choose Object and choose Expand Appearance. And now what happens is if I ungroup this, I can select each one of these individually. So first of all, it ungroups all 10 rows, and then if I need to, I can ungroup each row so that I can select the individual houses. I'll do that to this one as well. All right, so for the first one, we have 36.5%. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to make my first three rows of 10, which represents 30 houses, I'm going to make those purple. And then I want my first six houses on the next row to be purple. And then I want this house to be only half purple. So here's where we can use the clipping mask again. I'm going to select that house, Command C to copy, Shift Command V to paste. I'm going to take a rectangle and draw that out so that it's directly over the center, and I can make that rectangle purple. And I just want to make sure it's right in the center. I'm going to click on the copy that I made and bring that to front. That's going to be the mask. So if I choose Arrange, Bring to Front, and then I shift click on my rectangle, and then I choose Make Clipping Mask, and now I have the purple is in the shape of the icon, and that's just a copy. So my original color is showing through. So now I'm representing visually 36.5 out of 100%. Now I can do the same thing for the cats, and I need the first three rows to be pink because the percentage is 30.4%, and then the first house on the fourth row is going to be partially pink. So it's 0.4. That means it's a little bit less than half. So I'm going to do the same thing I did before. Command C to copy, Shift Command V to paste in place, create a rectangle. This one will be a little bit less than half. I'll take that rectangle and make it pink. I'm going to select my copy of the icon, bring to front. That's going to be my mask. I'm going to shift click on the pink rectangle and right click, choose Make Clipping Mask. At this point, I'm going to save. Let's add some percentages and a title to our graph. I'm going to drag out a text frame. I'm going to type in the percentage, 36.5, that's for dogs. Let's align center. We're going to choose Avenir Next and Regular. Size is 56 points. We'll make the tracking negative 75. And then I'm going to center this over my array for dogs. And I'm doing that just by dragging the ends of the text frame. And I'm just using the arrow keys to nudge that into position. Let's make that our purple color. Let's Command C to copy, Shift Command V to paste in place, click and drag over our cats array, and that is 30.4. And then we just need to change that color to pink. Next, we need a title. So the title is going to be all caps, percentage of households owning. And we're going to make that also is Avenir next, but we're going to make that bold, and we're going to make that 26 points. And again, we're going to make the tracking negative 75. And just making sure I'm missing a G. And we want each of these words to be on their own separate line. And actually, the tracking seems a little tight to me, so let's go with minus 25. Let's try that. We'll center that in between. And what I'm going to do is I want to align the bottom of this title with the bottom of these percentage numbers, so I'm going to drag down a guideline. The reason I'm doing this is because I want my infographic to be designed. I don't want things to be random. I want things to be neat and organized and look purposeful. And one way that you can achieve that is by aligning the various elements. This title looks pretty good, but I think we should just double check the leading, because I didn't set any leading for this, and it's kind of an odd number. So let's see what this looks like. 36. You know, I think it's pretty close. I'd like to make it an even number, though, so let's just type in 32. All right, and that does push it down below our guideline a bit, so I'm going to just go ahead and readjust that. Next thing we need to do is we don't have any place that says what these households are owning. I mean, we're assuming that it's cats and dogs, but we don't say it anywhere. So rather than just say the words cats and dogs, we're going to use icons to represent cats and dogs. So I've got some cat icons off to the side here, and this is the one that we're going to use. And he's facing the wrong way. I want him facing the opposite direction. So I'm going to choose the reflect tool. It's underneath the rotate tool. And with this still selected, I'm going to just drag with that rotate tool. And if I hold the shift key, it will lock it to 45 degree angles. All right, and then I'm going to change this to pink. So I'm using pink and purple to represent cats and dogs. I'm using them in a consistent way. So I'm using color, and I also want to use this principle of proximity where I have information that is related to each other close together. So I wouldn't want to put my cat way all the way up here because it just wouldn't make a lot of sense. So that's my rationale when I'm thinking about how should I size and position these illustrations. All right, so that looks okay. We've got dog illustrations all the way over here. So let's bring those a little bit closer. We're going to use this one. So I'm just going to drag that into position, change the color. I need to resize him a little bit, make him a bit smaller. He's facing the right direction, so we don't need to do anything there. That looks about right. Now, I'm just going to add one more thing to this. We have two different arrays of information, and I'm going to put a little ruled line in the center just to give it a little bit more of a visual separation. I'm just going to measure this by eye. I'm starting my rule at the top of the first house and ending it at the bottom of the last house. And we need to make the stroke 6, and the stroke color is going to be EF DFB6. So just a subtle separation, and then I'm going to drag that into the center of my array. And I think that's looking pretty close. Minor adjustments can always be made later, but at this point, I think we're ready to save.